So I believe when the results you showed us were comparing the mean scores on various measures, we also looked at
mean change. So we basically took every participant's baseline across the different health outcomes and tracked it each week. So we were assessing their severity of symptoms every week.
Okay. But you mentioned that the non-model participants had a pretty significant improvement. Did you also look at the fraction of individuals who had that clinical improvement and maybe that varied across the participant category?
It was a little muffled, but I think you were saying, did we look at of those that didn't have clinical meaningful improvement?
Well, it was just a response variable that was either yes, they had a clinical improvement, or no, they didn't.
Oh, I see. So we could have reported the data as what their score change percentage was, right? So on average, people's pain improved 30%, things like that. But in the world of medicine, these clinically meaningful cutoffs are more important. Because, like, I'll give you an example, right? I have a new drug. It'll improve your pain by 20%. Oh, yeah, 20%, that's pretty cool. But that actually doesn't really hit the cutoff for what is clinically meaningful. I think the cutoff's about 30%. And so what we went for in this study was to say, hey, if this were judged as a pharmaceutical drug, how would a doctor evaluate it? It would evaluate it based on the percentage of people using it that had a clinically meaningful difference in their pain or their sleep, their anxiety. Because if you just see your percentage, if your anxiety is 10% better, like, that's pretty cool. But does it warrant you paying money, potentially having side effects to try to get a product? Right? So we basically converted the percentage changes, the mean score changes, and saw how many of them hit that threshold for clinically meaningful. And that's how we got these numbers, right? 63% of people in the study had clinically meaningful improvement in anxiety. If you have a pharma drug that can demonstrate that, that is going to do very well. And insurance companies would be happy to reimburse for it. But again, this was an open label study. So some amount of that 63% of people, some portion of that improvement was probably being driven by the placebo effect, right? Just like anything. It's like anything that you study in an open label study, whether it's a supplement or meditation or a pharma drug. So that's why there needs to be additional studies on here, and this is just our first shot across the bow. So we're excited. I mean, in this last 30 days alone, we've probably run trials on 6,000 people, blinded randomized trials on CBD, CBG, CBN, CBC. So we're exploring a bunch of different products, but there's really infinite. Like, so much work to be done, so we need help. We need other researchers, we need other people